Dear students, this lecture is about the five color theorem. Statement: every planar graph is five vertex colorable. So let us see the proof of this statement. So first, let capital G be a planar graph. So first we shall consider a planar graph capital G. We have to prove that this planar graph G is five vertex colorable. So to prove that G is five vertex colorable. So in order to prove that G is five vertex colorable, we prove this theorem by the method of contradiction. So we prove this theorem by the method of contradiction. So now, on the contrary, let us assume that G is not five vertex colorable. Instead, let us assume that G is six vertex colorable and not five vertex colorable. Now, because G is six vertex colorable, we can say that the chromatic number of G is six, and so G is a K chromatic graph. That is, the value of K here is six. So G is a six chromatic graph. Because the chromatic number of G is 6. And we know that every K chromatic graph contains a K critical subgraph. Now here G is 6 chromatic, is a 6 chromatic graph, which implies G will contain a 6 critical subgraph. And let us denote that graph as H. So G contains six critical subgraph. So we are going to represent this subgraph as H. So G contains a six critical subgraph H. So the definition of critical graph is: a graph G is said to be K critical if chi of G is equal to K and chi of G minus V, that is a subgraph of G. After removing the vertex V, the subgraph obtained will be G minus V. So the chromatic number of that subgraph will be K minus 1 for every vertex V of G. So there is a property for the critical graph. It says that if a graph H is K critical, then the minimum degree of H will be greater than or equal to K minus 1. So now here G contains a 6 critical graph. So the value of K is equal to 6. And so from this property we obtain that delta of H is greater than or equal to 6 minus 1. So that implies delta of H is equal to, that is greater than or equal to 5. So because H is K critical, delta of H is greater than or equal to 5. So what will happen is delta of G will also be greater than or equal to 5, because H is a critical subgraph of G. And so therefore delta of G is greater than or equal to 5. So delta is greater than or equal to 5, and let us mark this as equation 1. Now, since G is a planar graph, there is a property for a planar graph which says that if G is a simple planar graph, then G has a vertex of degree less than 6. So, therefore, delta of G will be lesser than or equal to 5. That is, it is less than 6. So, it is strictly less than 6. Or it can be lesser than or equal to 5. So let us mark this as equation 2. So now, from equation 1 and equation 2, we obtain that delta is equal to 5. So therefore, the graph G has a vertex. So let us represent that vertex as V. So, it has a vertex V such that degree of V is equal to delta, which is equal to 5. Now, let us delete this vertex V from G. So, let us delete. Let us delete this vertex V from the graph G. So after deleting, the graph obtained will be G minus V. So let us represent this graph as G dash. So we are deleting the vertex V from G and we are obtaining a graph G minus V and representing that graph as G dash. Now we already know that G is 6 vertex colorable. This is by our assumption. So 6 vertex colorable because we have assumed in our theorem. Because G is 6 vertex colorable and G dash is a proper subgraph of G. So G dash is a proper subgraph of G. Because it is a proper subgraph which we obtained after deleting one vertex from G and G is 6 vertex colorable, then G dash will be 5 vertex colorable because G dash is a proper subgraph of G. So then G dash will be 5 vertex colorable. Now because G dash is 5 vertex colorable, we can form a chromatic partitioning of G dash. What is this chromatic partitioning? That is partitioning G dash, the vertices of G dash into sets where the set the vertex VI will represent the color class of those vertices which receive the same color. That is, now G dash is 5 vertex colorable and so it can be partitioned as, that is its vertices can be partitioned as V1, that is capital V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. So it can be partitioned into 5 vertex set, where V1 represents those vertices which receive color 1 and V2 represents those vertices which receive color 2 and similarly the other vertex set. So let this be a chromatic partitioning. Chromatic partitioning of G. G dash. So it represents the chromatic partitioning of G dash, where this VI, VI for I equal to, we have from 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, where this VI represents the color class, we call it as color class of those vertices corresponding to the color I. So corresponding to the color I. So those vertices which receives color I will be element of VI. Now we observe that the vertex which we deleted, that is the vertex V which we deleted from G, should be definitely adjacent to all those vertices which are elements of this partition sets. Because if it is adjacent only, then the because it is six colorable, that is G is six vertex colorable. If it is not adjacent, then G will become five vertex colorable. So definitely this deleted vertex V has to be adjacent to the elements of these partition sets. And so what will happen is degree of that vertex V will be equal to 5, because it is adjacent to the those 5 vertices. And let us consider those vertices as small v1, v2, v3, v4, v5. So these are the vertices that are adjacent to V. So this v1 will belong to the partition set capital V1. Similarly, V2 will belong to the partition set V2. So likewise, the other vertices also. So in general, we can say that the small VI belongs to the partition set capital VI, where I will be equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So now the vertex V is adjacent to 5 different vertices, that is vertex V1 receives color 1 and this receives color 2 and V3 receives color 3, okay? So and V4 receives color 4 and V5 receives color 5, okay? So now we shall consider a subgraph, okay? Let us denote by capital G I comma G. So this denotes a subgraph, okay? Let us denote capital G I comma J, which is a subgraph G of V I union V J, okay? So Gij represents the subgraph G of Vi union Vj, and this subgraph is induced by Vi union Vj. Okay. So now small Vi, that is the vertex Vi which is an element of this, and small vj which is an element of this, must belong to the same component of gi comma j. So these two must belong to the same component of gi comma j. So, if it does not belong to the same component, that is Vi and Vj, if not, then what will happen is they will be in different components. So, if they are in different components, so if for example, if Vi and Vj, I is 1 and J is 3, if these two are in different components, then what we can do, we can give the same color for these two vertices. Because if they are in different components, this vertex receives the color 1 and this vertex can also receive color 1. But what will happen, it will contradict, because the vertex V is adjacent to both of these vertices and they cannot receive the same color. Definitely they have to receive two different colors. So therefore, they have to be in the same component. So now let us put that into words. So Vi and Vj must belong to the same component. The reason is, and so if not, so if they don't belong to the same component, then what will happen? If not, then Vi and Vj will be in different components. So in that case, Vi and Vj will receive the same color. But it is a contradiction because both Vi and Vj are both adjacent to V. So they can receive only two different colors. Or else it will contradict the fact of color class that we have considered. It's not only the concept of adjacency. The main concept is we have assumed five different color class for the V1, V2, V3, V4 and V5. Okay, so if we assume that these two belong to different components, then that concept of color class becomes a contradiction. So if for that reason, it can be in only in the same component. It cannot be in two different components. So this enables us to find a path Pi, j joining the vertices Vi and Vg. So now we can find a path Pi, j. Now for instance, let us assume I is equal to 1 and j is equal to 3. Okay, so we will be considering the vertices V1 and V3, and there will be a path between V1 and V3 which can be represented as P1, 3. So now let us see that path in the diagram. So when we take the diagram, now this is vertex V1 and this is vertex V3. So there will be a path having some vertices in between. Then, or else it will become only one edge. So if it is a path, definitely there will be different vertices joining the vertex V1 and V3. So there is a path. Now the vertices of this path has to be colored alternatively with color 1 and color 3. Now because here it has received color 1, this has to be colored with color 3. Then again here with color 1 and then color 3, color 1. So alternatively it has to be colored with color 1 and 3. I have shown with less number of vertices here, but the path may contain more than these number of vertices. So for instance, I have shown this. So there is a path between the vertex V1 and V3, and let us denote this path as P1, 3. Then now we shall consider a cycle C. Now that cycle will be like, let us start from V. So V, V1. So this edge V, V1, and then the path, okay, so V, V1, then union the path P1, 3. So P1, 3, okay, and then union we have reached 3 after this path. Then the edge V3, so the edge V3, V. So let us consider this cycle. Now we observe that this cycle C, that is this cycle C, separates the vertex V2 and V4. Okay, it separates this vertex, and V2 is in the interior of the cycle and V4 belongs to the exterior of the cycle. So it follows from the Jordan curve theorem that if there can be, like how we had the path P1, 3, there can be another path P2, 4. But what will happen is when we have that path, it will intersect this curve. It will intersect at a point where we cannot have an edge, because it will contradict the fact of planar graph now. If it is going to intersect, and we cannot have an edge over there, because the vertices of P2, 4 have colors 2 and 4, whereas no vertex of C has either of these colors. So therefore, this contradiction proves that it contradicts the fact that our graph is a planar graph. So this contradiction proves that our assumption that G is 6 vertex colorable is wrong, and therefore G can be only 5 vertex colorable. Now let us put this into words. So since C separates V2 and V4, V2 will be in interior of C and V4 will be in exterior of C. Therefore, from the Jordan curve theorem, it follows that the path P2, 4 must meet the curve in some point. this point must be a vertex because G is planar. But this is impossible because since the vertices of P2, 4 have colors 2 and 4, whereas no vertex of C has either of these colors because the path has only two colors, either color 1 or color 2. So if that the path between this and this has to meet, then it can meet at some point, but that point can receive only any of these two colors, and it cannot receive color from 2 and 4 also, color 2 and 4, because of it being touching the curve. So therefore we cannot have the graph G to be 6 vertex colorable, and hence it has to be 5 vertex colorable. So our assumption that G is 6 vertex colorable is wrong. Therefore G has to be 5 vertex colorable. So therefore every planar graph can be only 5 vertex colorable. So therefore every planar graph is 5 vertex colorable. Hence we have proved the theorem. Hope you have understood the proof. Thank you.